I have found that a lot of people stumble and even get angry when you speak about God's election. And to me, that's very sad because the Bible is full of it. The people of Israel were clearly chosen by God. I mean, Abraham was chosen by God, Isaac by God, Jacob, who later on was called Israel, was clearly chosen by God. And when the Lord Jesus Christ came onto this planet, he again chose 12 disciples, whom he called apostles. He chose them. Paul is another example himself. He used to be Saul, and the Lord deliberately reached out to him while he was persecuting the church and brought him to himself. And when you read the Bible, it is there as an actual teaching, especially in a passage like Romans 9, 10, and 11. It clearly teaches that God chose us before the creation of the world, that he was going to save us. Ephesians chapter 1 also teaches the same. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Again, why? He chose us in him, that is in Christ, before the creation of the world. So again and again, this is a biblical teaching. God has chosen us. Now, again, one of the reasons why people stumble up on this issue is because they fail to give it a context. How should we understand God's election? The best way to phrase it is God's electing love. God's electing love. In other words, it is out of love, in fact, out of grace, that whereas he has passed others by, he has reached out to those whom he intends to save, and consequently sent his Son to die for their sins, and also sent his Spirit to convict, to regenerate, and to bring them to himself. It is an act of love. It is an act of his goodness. The best way to perhaps illustrate it, but like all illustrations, it is weak. Nonetheless, it helps us to capture this, is the way in which a young man finds a wife. There are a lot of women in his church, there are a lot of women in his school, college, university, or his workplace, but he, out of love, specifically reaches out to one that he makes his wife. It's an act of love. And therefore, we ought to be overwhelmed that despite our sin, which God clearly brings into the equation, he still reaches out to choose us as those he would save. If that doesn't overwhelm you, I don't know what will. Election shows very clearly that our God is a God of infinite love.